Today we are talking about what's called electronegativity. First thing is, what is electronegativity? Here's a definition for you, and it's a good one to memorize. It's the strength with which an element will pull electrons towards itself in a bond. So when two elements are bonded together, the more electronegative element is the one that's stronger. There's this tug of war that's going on for the electrons between two atoms when they're bonded to each other. And the one that's more electronegative is stronger in that tug of war and pulls the electrons to some degree more towards itself and away from the other atom, the element, other element in the bond. Now, the electronegativity is just a number, it has no units, and pretty much every element you can look up an electronegativity for. These are the ones that I'm asking you to memorize. Hydrogen, all of the second row of the periodic table, and the halogens, none of the others. But there is a trend. So the trend is that electronegativity of an element increases as you go up and to the right in the periodic table. This does not include the noble gases. You can look up electronegativities for most of the noble gases, but generally they don't tend to form bonds to other atoms, and so we're not going to even talk about their electronegativities. So other than the noble gases, electronegativity increases up and to the right. That means fluorine is the most electronegative element. Now, I'm asking you to memorize these numbers here, and it's pretty easy once you see the trends. Well, first of all, hydrogen, that's just flat out memorize it, 2.1. However, in the second row, lithium through fluorine, if you start with 1.0 for lithium, just add 0.5 for each element, and it keeps on going up. 1, 1.5, 2, 2.5, 3, 3.5, and 4, lithium, the most electronegative element. Now, there's a pattern as we go down the halogens. It's a little bit more strained, but here's how I remember it. I remember it as 1, 2, 3, 4. If you look at the difference in electronegativity between fluorine and chlorine, it's 1, 4 to 3 is 1. And then between chlorine and bromine, it's 0.2, right? So 1, 2, get it? And then between bromine and iodine, it's 0.3, and iodine and acetine, it's 0.4. But whatever it takes, memorize these numbers and also memorize the trend, and that is that other than noble gases, electronegativity increases up and to the right in the periodic table. So for example, in this molecule here, hydrogen bonded to fluorine. Fluorine has an electronegativity of 4.0 and hydrogen's 2.1. So fluorine is the more electronegative element. And that means that it's pulling on the electrons, these two electrons here in the bond, towards itself more strongly than hydrogen is. So it pulls them partially away from the hydrogen. Not entirely. These two electrons, they're still in between the two atoms, but they're shifted more towards the fluorine than they are the hydrogen. And what happens when you gain a little bit of those electrons, you gain a little bit of a negative charge. So fluorine in this bond has a little bit of a negative charge. We can write it two ways. This is supposed to be a lowercase Greek delta for partial, a partial negative charge here. And if you pull electrons away from an element, you give it a part of a positive charge. So the hydrogen, because the electrons are being pulled slightly away from it, has not a full-blown positive charge, but a partial positive charge. So we write it like this. We can also write it with this arrow. The arrow points towards the more electronegative element, where the electrons are being pulled towards, and a little hatch on the end where the electrons are being pulled away from. Now that we know about electronegativities, we have a better way of defining what kind of bond and consequently what kind of compound something is. If the difference in electronegativity, this delta En stands for the difference in electronegativity between two elements, is bigger than 1.9, we call that an ionic bond. And we'll do some examples in just one second. If the difference in electronegativity between two elements is bigger than 0.4 but less than or equal to 1.9, then we call that a covalent bond, and in particular a polar covalent bond. Polar just means that there are two poles, one's positive, one's negative, like the posts in your battery in your car, one's positive, one's negative. Those are poles. So if we go back and look at this compound here, the difference in electronegativity, the delta En for this bond, is 4.0 minus 2.1. What you do, you always just take the one that has the larger electronegativity minus the one that has the lower. So 4.0 0.0 minus 2.1 is 1.9, that's what we call a polar covalent bond. Covalent means that it's not ionic, so it's a molecule, a molecular compound, but the electrons are shifted towards the fluorine, giving it a negative pole here and a positive pole on the hydrogen. Now, if the difference in electronegativity is smaller than or equal to 0.4, that's a covalent bond, but it's nonpolar. That just means that neither of the elements is really strong enough to pull the electrons appreciably towards itself. And that means that the electrons in that bond are not shifted one way or the other, meaning they're spread more or less evenly between the two atoms, and there's no negative end, no positive end, so it's nonpolar. So memorize these numbers, these definitions. So for example, if we look at a bond between a beryllium atom and a chlorine atom, the difference in electronegativity, the delta En, is 3 minus 1.5, chlorine's 3.0, beryllium's 1.5, and the difference is 1.5, 3 minus 1.5, and that makes it a polar covalent bond. Now notice, look, beryllium's a metal, chlorine's a nonmetal. So up to this point, we would have called that an ionic bond, because that's how we knew an ionic bond, a metal and a nonmetal. But now that we know about electronegativities, we can say that that's not an ionic bond, but rather a polar covalent bond. On the other hand, if we look at a bond between lithium and oxygen, lithium's 1.0, its electronegativity. Oxygen's 3.0, the difference, the delta En, is 2.0, making that an ionic bond. And then if we look at carbon-hydrogen bonds, carbon's 2.5, hydrogen's 2.1, the delta En, the difference in electronegativity, is 0.4, making this a nonpolar covalent bond.